Multiple identifier changes, user interface, and validation errors. So here are the changes in the mid-resolution process. The user interface will display all records in consideration for the merge. So the student enrollment, student information, student English language acquisition, and student with disability status records will show the entire history. And these records were selected because they are the type of records that cause data conflicts that are harder to resolve as the result of a mid-merge. Additionally, a pop-up message will serve as an extra warning for users when combining merges may result in a concurrent enrollment. Now for the validation errors. The SWDS0648 duplicate plan students with disability status effective start date. This error triggers when both records share the same students with disability status effective start date. This is a fatal error and will prevent the mid combination. The SELA 0326 will also run against a potential mid combination. The name of this error is the ELAS start date already exists for a student, so it's pretty straightforward. This error triggers when the potential mid combination contains SSIDs with duplicate ELAS or English language acquisition status start dates. This has been a big problem in the past with mid combinations. And the SELA 0255 invalid change in English language acquisition status code. This triggers when the result of a mid-merge would create an out-of-sequence SELA history. In the mid-resolution process, both the SELA 0326 and the SELA 0255 are warnings and will not prevent the combination of a mid. Before we demonstrate the upcoming changes, let's go over a few reminders. The changes are to improve the resolution process. They do not prevent the user from requesting multiple identifiers for a single student or creating a mid. LEAs must still exercise their due diligence when requesting and assigning SSIDs. Continue to refine your local enrollment processes to avoid creating mids. As always, we suggest you begin your SSID enrollment process by using the SSID match tool, identifying those students that have been previously assigned SSIDs and importing those SSIDs into your SIS or your student information systems. This will go a long way into preventing the creation of mids. Even with the changes and improvements, avoiding creating mids is easier to manage than resolving them. All right, so here we are in the test environment on the mid resolution screen. And let's go over these changes. Let's look at this first student, Sliman. We'll open the record. All right, so in the mid-resolution details, you can see the fatals and the warnings. And we've identified three potential warnings here, CCE, SELA 0255. The result of the mid combination will make the SELA history out of sequence. The English language acquisition status won't have a logical flow. And then the SELA 0326, if this mid was combined, there will be two records with the same status start date. If that is an IFEP or an EL record, it cannot be deleted by the end user. A data request would have to be made. Problematic. So this is the same, right? We have the focus SSID, the matching SSID, general information to help us compare the two student records. And then what's new is you can see the SENR, the SINF, the SELA, and the SWDS. So here, you can see that there's warnings indicated on the records in the enrollment history that are causing the conflict. Since a CCE would occur, it's indicated. It's only a warning because these are two different school districts. So this is very typical in the mid and will not prevent it. Now the SINF, you see there's multiple records here. You have the student's demographic history. You don't have the complete history, but you have additional fields like the parent guardian's name, the race code, and the birth city that can help you identify whether or not This is a single student with two SSIDs or two different students. So this is very useful having the container, not just to identify discrepancies, but to help you identify whether or not this is a mid. And then we have the SELA, the Student English Language Acquisition. You can see that the warnings for the 0326 and the 0255 or the SELA 0255. And then we have those fields related to the SELA status. They can help you identify whether or not this is a true mid or different students, but the SELA is really not reliable for that. Students often have discrepancies in their SELA history if they enroll in different schools or if different parents enroll them. And then if the student had any students with disability status, that would be listed here. Now remember, there's a CCE. So if we were to say this is a student with two SSIDs and we want to combine the mid, we click the merge button and the pop-up appears. Combining these SSIDs will result in a concurrent enrollment. Ensure they are the same student. This action cannot be undone. Continue to post. In this instance, we're going to say no. And let's look at another student. So we're going to look at Joshua Tree here. We'll open this student's record. Now you can see we have a fatal error. There's a CCE within the LEA, right? So if this was a submitted file, that would be equivalent to a SENR 0027 error, right? And so this is fatal. And if we scroll down to the enrollment record, you can see the fatal error is indicated. All the discrepant records, whether they're a fatal error or a warning, are identified. And down here at the bottom, we have no buttons, right? No merge button, no different button. So the fatal error will prevent us from making any actions as far as a mid combination is concerned here. So let's look at another set of students real quickly. Okay, so here we have Captain America. And we open this record. We see that we have no errors. So this is a mid that we could combine. We'd still want to make comparisons between the focus SSID and the matching SSID. And we have the enrollment history, the student information, SELA status, and the students with disability status, right? We'd want to compare the information provided and prior to combining the mid, ensure it is the same student. What I want to bring your attention to is here at the top, we have next SSID. So this focus SSID has multiple candidates. So you notice how the matching SSID has changed. Likewise, the information container has changed because we're comparing the new SSID. And the same functionality or similar functionality can be expected in terms of validations when you run a resolve mid not on report. In the event that you identify students that may be potential mids and you want to use the mid not on report function, you'll still have the same validations. Well, here you can see that we have a SWDS 0648. The student has existing SWDS records with the same special education effective start date. So I cannot combine these two records. Fatal error, it prevents it. So again, we had Captain America here. We're going to merge. Here's the result of the merge. So we see we have Captain America again. This is the SSID that was retained. We'll open the record. And now we just have a MID with two SSIDs. We have the focus SSID and the matching SSID. And we have that same SWDS0648 error. And that will prevent the combination. Notice no buttons at the bottom. So we have to resolve that in the student detail screen prior to combining the MID if these are the same student. So hopefully you find this preview of the changes to the MID functionality useful. And we hope the upcoming changes increase the usability of CalPADS and the functionality in the MID resolution process.